Hello friends, welcome back to Channel NEET, and today we are going to continue with the topic that is known as the biological classification, and today is lecture number 6. Today's topic that we are going to deal is modern concept of classification. So in modern concept of classification, we are going to see two kingdom of classification. We are going to see three kingdom of classification. We are going to see four kingdom of classification. We are going to see five kingdom of classification. We are going to see six kingdom of classification. So in modern concept of classification, we are going to see two kingdom of classification, three kingdom of classification, four kingdom of classification, five kingdom of classification and six kingdom of classification in details. So let's start with the first topic, that is two kingdom classification. So we are going to deal with two kingdom of classification. So the first point, it is oldest system of classification. It was suggested by Carolus Linnaeus. In 1758, he divided living organism in two parts, animals and plants. Animals were motile and plants were non-motile. So, on the mobility factor, he classified animal and plant. Fourth, demerits are could not classify organism like bacteria, fungi and Euglena. So this was the simplest classification that was given by Carolus Linnaeus. We'll quickly revise some important points. Okay, it is the oldest system of classification. It was suggested by Carolus Linnaeus in year 1758. Okay, he divided them into all living organism into living animal and living plants. Okay, fine. On the basis of motile, okay, the mobility becomes an important factor of his classification. demerit that it could not classify bacteria, fungi and Euglena. So this was one of the demerit that we could see in two system classification suggested by Carlos Linnaeus. So here we complete the two system classification pattern. Now we'll be seeing of the three kingdom classification. Let's start with three kingdom classification pattern. First, it was given by Ernest Haeckel. In year 1866, he introduced third kingdom, that is Protista. He was a German biologist and philosopher. Fourth point, he suggested Kingdom Protista for unicellular organism such as bacteria, protozoans, zoans, and unicellular algae. He also suggested Protista for multicellular organism, multicellular organism, which do not have tissues, could be classified under Protista. Example, algae and fungi. So according to Haeckel, we have three kingdoms: Plantae, Animalia and Protista. So this classification was done by Ernest Haeckel. We'll quickly revise some important points in this. So it was given by Ernest Haeckel, the third kingdom was referred as Protista. Okay, he was a German biologist and philosopher. Okay, he suggested for unicellular organisms, the example are bacteria, protozoan and unicellular algae. The next point is with respect to the multicellular organism. He says those organisms which do not have tissues, okay, would be considered or classified under Protista. Okay, the example of algae and the fungi. Okay. And the three kingdom what we have known by 1866 is Plantae, Animalia and Protista. So here we conclude three kingdom of classification. Now we'll see of the four kingdom of classification. So now let's see the four kingdom classification. First, it was given by Copeland in year 1956. The kingdom which he suggested, which he introduced, was Monera. Third point, it includes all prokaryotes. Fourth point, he also classified protists like protozoan in kingdom Monera. Point number fifth, the main demerit is that it could not classify fungi. So this becomes very important point. So let's quickly revise about the four kingdom of classification given by Copeland in 1956. He introduced the kingdom Monera. It includes all prokaryotics. He classified some protozoans into the Monera, and demerit is with respect to the classification of fungi. So now we have four kingdoms which are as follow: Plantae, Animalia, Protista and Monera. So we could get four kingdoms. So here we complete four kingdom classification system. We'll stop up here today. Hope you liked today's video. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.